15 is a time where I really believe that what we're going to start to do is we're going to start to honor the word of God in a different way. You know, if you sit with a pastor and you are called into a church, whichever church you go to, and you sit with a pastor, you sit with a minister, and they give you wisdom and they give you counsel, right? Do you know if you don't take that wisdom and counsel and you go, oh, no, it's under grace, it's fine. We're coming into a time where the fear of the Lord is going to come on people to such an extent that there's going to be no excuses, and you will start to reap the consequences of not taking counsel more quickly. I really believe that, because God is over the dishonor. Too much dishonor in the body. Way too much. There's no one here. I'm just saying, way too much dishonor. And it's clouded by, no, we're all good, we're all free. You are all free. But David said, I will not lay a finger on the Lord's anointed. Well, when you draw time and you don't honor the time that you're drawing, it's the same as actually it's making a withdrawal from somebody and actually not stewarding that. And it's, do you know what it's like? It's like, if Jesus was here and he told you something, would you listen? Well, and I'm not saying pastors and ministers and prophets and all these guys are always right, but they are God's representatives. So even when you honor the word that comes, and this is like the fear of control thing, people say, oh, no. When you honor the word, that God will honor the fact that you honored the word. It's amazing. So I really feel like we're just moving into... I feel like everyone's like... just really feel like we're going into a time where you're really going to strategically honor time with people that you're drawing from and that you're actually asking wisdom from. And I'm telling you right now, it will literally get to the stage where you will feel, I said it before, you'll actually feel the fear of God. Because James Gold spoke this word ages ago about Jubilee, and he says, the fear of God is going to be teamed with immense joy. It's going to be joy and fear of the Lord. And we want that, and we've got the joy. But I can tell you right now that it's also going to come with a wake-up call. And how many of you know, if someone's in a slumbering state, you have to give them a quick slap to wake them up, some cold water? How many of you know that's true? Well, how many of you think that God would do that? Of course he does. He wants people to be awake and ready and understanding the way things work and the way things operate. It's good. Am I a time waster? I don't know. You tell me. It's true. It's very good. Okay. New beginnings. We're in a new day. Listen, we're in a new day. This is a new time. And whatever it is that you've been struggling with or things that you never, ever seem to manage to get the breakthrough in over the year upon year upon year, I really believe that God is saying, as you renew your mind, as you start to believe again afresh that nothing is impossible for God, that 2015 and beyond are going to be your years of unprecedented breakthrough in particular areas. And it was so funny. I said, God, you release the same words sometimes this year and that year and that year. And I said, what is it? Like, what is it? And he said, I'm waiting for people to change. I was like, wow. Well, and does God speak like that? Absolutely. Because he's waiting for us to agree. How many of you know that Mary was ready? She was. She didn't have to go, okay, come back in 12 months, give me the same word and I'll see. She said, be it unto me according to your word. Well, if you take this today, I really mean it, it will do something. It should shift something in your spirit, in your heart. It should. If it doesn't, then you didn't receive it. Or you don't need it. You see what I'm saying? See what I'm saying? But it should provoke something within you and saying, actually, you know what? I have been praying for this thing for 3 years, 4 years, 5 years. You've been in counseling more than 5 years. I'm not saying each person is an individual, but it's, as Izzy said earlier, it's a time where we're actually coming out of it's like the navel gazing in the body. It's just boring and it's time consuming. Don't you think it's time consuming? How many people are bored of thinking about your problems and yourself? If I could just fix this, if I could just fix that, if I could... Well, we've been singing for a long time now. Nothing broke, nothing missing, nothing broken, if I remembered. Nothing missing. No, imagine that was your decree as you walk into next year. There's nothing missing. There's nothing broken in my life. And I'm ready for God to do anything he wants to do, even if it seems impossible. Even if it seems ridiculous. It's a time of big vision. I don't know how long I've been speaking, but I feel like to land. So if that speaks to you, can I pray? Is that sure? Listen, if that speaks to you, I want you to stand up. Don't worry about anyone else. Don't worry if your neighbor stood up. And just by you standing right now, you're agreeing with the word. You really are. And this isn't about you going on a long heart journey with the Lord at all. Quite the opposite. It's you throwing off the things which can easily entangle you and running a race with perseverance, the race that's marked out for you. And it's saying, okay, God, be it unto me according to your word. And so what we're choosing to do as we're standing is we're choosing to say, God, any word that you want to resurrect from the past or anything new that you're releasing, be it unto me according to your word, that I will stand and I will believe afresh and I will choose to not partner, consider, remember, or bring to mind the former things which have been negative, the things that have caught me up in the past, the places of unbelief where I didn't think I'd actually get a breakthrough, and I'm instead going to see everything from now with a new, clear view. Thinking new, a fresh view. And so, Father, I receive, just say, I receive a fresh view for 2015, 2016, and beyond, in the name of Jesus. And everybody said, amen. Amen. Awesome. So we're going to pray for many people for healing right now. And it might be emotional, it might be physical. I feel like someone had a problem someone had an accident where the brain was damaged. There was a minor brain damaged area. I want to pray for that person as well from an accident. But whatever it is that you need prayer for, I'm going to invite the team to come up. We're going to go into a ministry time right now. And if there was something that spoke to you specifically that you feel like, actually, I need someone to partner with me just on that bit, not for you to regurgitate your story for 25 minutes, but for you to actually say, this happened and I want to move past this, will you just partner with me that I'm able to get breakthrough in that particular area? So if that speaks to you, I'm going to invite you to come up and say, if the team can come now and make yourselves ready to pray for people. But we really believe that this is the second to last service before the new year, and we really believe that there is going to be significant change. And if you want to, and you, not everyone needs to get prayer, just to let you know. But honestly, there's a partnering right now, and you are going to see significant change if you genuinely say, actually, enough is enough. And the Lord said, I said this at the beginning, but the Lord said, there will be no more going around the mountain. There will be no more going around the mountain. If you are tired of going around the mountain, then this is your time to say, actually, I'm ready to move into the new thing. So the team are ready. I'm not going to ask for, I'll ask for specific healing words of knowledge, but not too in-depth emotional words, if that's cool. So if you guys have words for physical healing, but we're going to pray whatever healing you need. So you can just come up and pray, and we're going to have a CD running, and be massively blessed. You can get your kids in a few minutes. Yeah, in a few minutes, go and collect your kids. But before that, let's just have some music and let's just move into some ministry.